Hello friends, I am NK Jain from Skill on Tech. Today I am coming with another video, floating head heat exchanger maintenance and testing. As we know, heat exchangers are generally fixed end or floating head. So we will discuss about floating head heat exchanger maintenance. If you like this video, kindly share it with your friends and colleagues. Floating head heat exchanger. Floating head heat exchangers are widely used for service where the temperature is high between shell and tube bundle, or dirty service such as petroleum refinery. A floating head type heat exchanger is a type of shell and tube heat exchanger in which the tube sheet assembly is free to move within the shell or shell cover. This is because due to high temperature, expansion takes place in the steel tubes, which resulted expansion of complete tube bundle. If one end of tube bundle is not kept movable or a tolerance is not provided to expand it, then there are chances of failure of tubes. Therefore, floating head heat exchangers are widely used in the industries, process industries. These heat exchangers provide us high thermal efficiency, corrosive air currents, cooling applications, high temperature service. The standards which are used for manufacturing of these heat exchangers are TAMA R, applicable for all our HX. Let us see a general assembly view of a floating head heat exchanger. Here in this picture, you can see this is a tube side inlet, and this is a distributor, and this is a tube side outlet. The nozzle which is shown is a tube side outlet. This is a completely shell, and this is a shell side inlet, and this is a shell side outlet. And this head which is shown here is a floating head which will expand along with the tubes in the heat exchanger shell. And this is a back cover. This is a settle supports, and this is a tube sheet which is shown here, and this one is a gasket which is shown as a different color. So this is a complete general assembly view of a floating head heat exchanger. Let us see cross sectional view. You can see here it is a distributor. These are tube side inlet and outlet. This is a tube bundle. These are baffle plates. This is a shell body. This is a floating head, and this is a floating head cover, back cover. These are supports for erection of this installation of heat exchanger. So this is a cross-sectional view of floating head heat exchanger. Now let us see split view of parts. This already we have shown. This is a distributor which is in the side of channel cover. This is a gasket. This is a tube sheet, this one, and this is also tube sheet. These are baffles. This is a split ring. Here spacer may come. This is a gasket. This is a floating head. Then again one gasket, and this is a shell cover, back cover. Shell of this heat exchanger will be erected on some concrete masonry support, and this is a floating head details. you can see in a cross-sectional. These tubes are generally SS stainless steel or maybe carbon steel, but generally stainless steel tubes are used in the process industries. If there is a corrosive atmosphere or corrosive fluid to be handled with the tubes, then this SS316 tubes or SS304 tubes can be used. And if welding is involved, then SS316L or SS304L tubes are used. Baffle plates may be carbon steel or may be SS depending upon requirement and application. Shell is generally of carbon steel, and this shell covers, floating head, this distributor cover, all are generally made of carbon steel. Procedure for maintenance and safety work permit. As we know, in all industries, before commencing a job for maintenance, we have to take safety work permit or job work permit. So we must ensure that job work permit or safety work permit is issued prior to commence the job. So prior to dismantling, ensure this job work permit or safety work permit is issued for the maintenance work. All workers are trained and skilled to carry out work. It is a duty of engineer to brief the description of work and safety aspects of working to the working personnel prior to commencement of the job. All standard and correct tools and tackles are to be used. All standard rigging practices shall be used, and material handling devices such as crane and chain pulley blocks, ceilings shall be tested and certified for use. So let us see maintenance activity description. You can see this is a crane and this is a tube bundle puller, and this is our heat exchanger. So blind inlet outlet at plant area, from where any process liquid can come in into this exchanger, that should be blind shall be inserted and ensured that nothing should come into the heat exchanger while working. The heat exchanger shall be completely drained before commencing the job. Tag shall be put on the inlet outlet walls. Not to operate tags shall be provided there. After complete draining of the heat exchanger and after issue of safety work permit, disconnect the channel cover, remove the gaskets, disconnect the shell cover, remove the gaskets, disconnect the floating head with gasket, and install the bundle puller, pull the bundle out. Lower the tube bundle and take it for hydrojetting. Clean shell and covers. We shall also ensure if there is any liners are provided in the shell, in the shell cover, in the shell, in the back cover, then all those liners shall be checked for any damage. All liners testing is also essential during the maintenance of the heat exchanger. Liners shall be tested pneumatically. We shall put some air pressure up to 1 kg and all liners are checked for any leakage. If any leakage is observed, any damage is observed, then liners shall be repaired with due standard procedure. Carry out the eddy current testing of tubes and find defective tubes. Lift the tube bundle puller with clean bundle and new gasket and keep it ready for reinstallation. If we found any defective tubes during the eddy current testing, then tubes shall be plugged or tubes can be replaced with due procedure. On maximum 10% of the tubes of any heat exchanger can be plugged If tubes are defective more than 10%, then we have to replace the tubes. Otherwise, flow capacity of heat exchanger will be reduced, and that may be a problem for our process parameters. Therefore, we shall ensure that the tubes plugged are not more than 10% of the total tubes. All the tubes are cleaned, hydrojetting is done properly, all liners are repaired, tested, certified, and then only we have to start reinstallation of tube bundle. Reinsert the tube bundle by puller and lower the bundle puller to ground and take it away. Here in this picture you can see a floating head view. This is a floating tube sheet. This is a packing which is provided during testing. Packing land. This is a gasket. This is a shell flange. And this is a test ring. So you can see a view of a test ring during testing towards floating head side. After complete maintenance of heat exchanger, plugging of tubes, repair of liners in the shell cover, channel cover, hydrojetting of complete tubes, eddy current of all the tubes, we have to carry out hydro test of shell side to detect the leakage in tubes. If any tube is defective and it is having communication with shell, then we have to provide a hydro test pressure from shell side. In this case, the hydro test pressure shall be provided through this shell side nozzle through a water pump. So this is water pump, and the pressure of water will goes into the shell, and if any communication is there, then we have to observe the leakage from tubes. Prior to that, we have to install test rings both the side of channel cover and shell cover with new gaskets, and they shall be properly tightened. And after pressurizing the shell, the defective tube will start flowing from here, water, and we can observe the defective tube. If there is no water is coming from tubes, it means all the tubes are intact, in a good condition. If any tubes are found leakage, then tubes shall be plugged and expanded both the sides, and it shall be TIG welding shall be done the tubes for sealing. So you can see in this picture that if tube is leaking, then from both sides it shall be plugged, both the ends, and it shall be expanded or TIG welded. So this is a general procedure which is followed. The maximum limit for plugging is 10% of number of tubes of exchange. Post test jobs. After testing of heat exchanger, we have to discharge water from shell drain, remove testing and gasket distributor side, reinstall distributor with new gasket and tight all the bolts and properly torqued with torque wrench, blind distributor in and out, remove testing and gasket floating head side, reinstall floating head with split flange, new gasket, and tight the bolts with torque wrench with a proper torque suitable to size of the studs or bolts. The torque value will depend upon the lubrication used, grease or mollycot. If mollycot is used, then torque value will be different. If grease is used, torque value will be different. So accordingly, torque value will be selected as per size of the bolt with the lubrication, and then they shall be properly torqued. After completion of tube leakage test, we have to see the shell side test. For that, we have to do pressurized tube side pressurization to check shell side. In this case, we have to install pressure gauge and distributor top nozzle as shown here, connect water pump, fill tube side by water, raise the pressure up to value given by inspection, check floating head gasket sealing, check distributor gasket seal. So once floating head is installed, this, then after proper torquing and tightening, now we have pressurized this from this tube side, and from here water will goes into the channel tubes, and we have to check any leakage from the shell cover gasket, floating head gasket and this gasket. If there is no leakage found, then our installation is suitable and correct. Now we have to go for shell side final hydro test. Install back cover with gasket, connect water pump, fill shell side by water, raise the pressure up to value given as per inspection, check back cover gasket sealing, check bundle to shell gasket sealing, discharge the water, remove PG and water pump. After completion of the test, remove blinds from shell nozzle and tighten all the bolts, remove the water pump from this, and if there is no leakage found from any gaskets, any flange joints, it means the heat exchanger is ready to take into the system to line up again the process. Handover and final housekeeping. Prepare maintenance and test certificate and duly signed by inspection authority. Keep complete history card, maintenance details on record. Carry out housekeeping of area. Connect the HX with the system. Return job work permit duly signed by maintenance engineer to process engineer or shift charge engineer. Return all tools and tackles to tool crew. So this is all about the maintenance and testing of floating head heat exchanger. Hope you may like this video and will give your comments and suggestions for new videos. Thank you. Thanks for watching the video. If you like this video, hit like button below. Share it with your friends and colleagues. Subscribe our channel for getting updates on upcoming videos. Please leave any comments, feedback to improve the videos. Thank you.